when I met Peter, it was really early, even before I started my publishing company. I was working on doing research and pulling manuscripts out of archives and things and trying to get translations done. And he was encouraging me, and so we were talking about the hermetic material and having those kinds of conversations. So when Shower of Stars came out, he gifted it to me, but I had no idea he was working on it. We did have conversations about the Taoist side of things, but more along the lines of the cloud writing and, the flying phoenix, things like this. But I didn't know he was working on it at the time.
That's funny, yeah. I mean, he's probably working on tons of things all at once, all the time.
Absolutely. Absolutely. I mean, he was so prolific.
No.
He was just always writing and rewriting. To tell you the truth, I'm not even sure how he was able to do all the things he was doing in terms of writing, because he not only was he so deeply re well read, but he was keeping up with things too. So he always seemed to know about the new things that were coming out,
There's a
and
sponge.
then was working on expanding the ideas, his ideas behind these things.
Yeah. It reminds me of that. There's that one term that he kind of focuses on in the book, surplus meaning. And he connects that to like Zhuangzi and the spillover words, I think is the term. But I really appreciated that way of talking about it, that there's a kind of excess at play. And that's also in the shower of stars, the cascading of kind of divine sparks, if you will.
It's the inspiration that can fill in these forms, right?
Right.
The form of the language or the form of the image needs to be enlivened,
Yeah.
with life force. And I think that spillover is really kind of the inspiration that can be molded. It's the opportunity to mold these things in the directions that the practitioner wants to engage in, right? Because you can use the tools, or you can be used as a tool
Right.
by these things.
Yeah, I mean that it seems to be a part of his larger kind of calling in a lot of ways. Well, he states it explicitly in the book to like re-paganize monotheism. You know, that seems to be like this reiterated thing and kind of liberate oneself from authoritarian powers. Rooting language in the dream, you are rooting it in the inspiratory moment, in the lived experience of the creation of the sign. Of the voice. And it's so beautiful how he articulates it.
He's so poetic. His
Yeah.
language is so poetic. And I think clearly that's one of his strengths, right? The strength of his writing is his poetics. But he really had this understanding that he tried to communicate to people about how language works. And maybe it's a losing battle, but I feel like it really falls on blind eyes a lot. People
Yeah.
don't quite understand the lesson behind language.